Hello dear student, I am Varun Nishad from LPM Public School. In this video, we will discuss the chapter 5, that is periodic classification of element. So, we have already discussed from the starting, that is periodic classification of elements. Periodic classification of elements. Dear student, we are already discussed from this topic. Familiar from the topic? The initial time in 1774 and 1805, Antoni L. Lavoisier. Antoni L. Lavoisier and 1805, John Dalton. These are the important scientists to contribute in the chemistry which laid the foundation of the modern chemistry. And they only categorized that in their classification, not to the arrangement for the element. They only classified the element into metal and non-metal and metal only. But there is no discussion of their chemical property, physical property, and their all things. But the periodic classification, the first laid by the 1817, John Wolfgang Dobberlier. He stated that he gave the law, and the law name is very important, that is Trianon. In the first time, 1817, the first time the John the Wolfgang Dobberlier, he was a German scientist, and he the arrangement of periodic classification of elements with their increasing atomic weight. Later it will distribute this time atomic masses. So Trianon, he stated that Trianon is the he arranged their similar properties of Trianon like that. He took their arrangement of three elements, that is lithium, sodium, and potassium. He stated that the first thing, it is very important, the mass of metal element is equal to arithmetic mean of first and third element. So what are their atomic masses on that time? That was given by John Dobberlier. Let us see. If you have a lithium, that is a atomic mass 6.9. If you have a sodium, that is atomic mass 23, and their potassium, that is 39.1. According to the Dobberlier trials, if we add this and this atomic mass, it will be converted into 6.9 and 39.1, that it will be equal to and these 23 arithmetic mean of these two elements which are present in the group first and group second and group third. So in group first, the lithium, sodium, potassium are the elements by the Dubernian, and you see that the first and third arithmetic mean will equal to the mass of middle element, that is 23, that is 23 is also, you are able to see in this board. तो इस तरह से उन्होंने ट्रायड्स को अपने एक्सप्रेस किया था, द मास ऑफ मिडिल एलिमेंट इज इक्वल टू अरिथमेटिक मीन ऑफ द फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड एलिमेंट व्हिच ऑफ द ट्रायड्स ऑफ डुबर्नियन. सिमिलरली द कैल्शियम इज स्ट्रॉन्शियम एंड बेरियम आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट, एंड अगेन द क्लोरीन the fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine are also present. But in this time there is no matchable, no application are matched towards the follow of law of Priors of the Dubernian, which is a very in this time, which is the way towards these things. It is so the limitations of John Dubernian is that in this time their trials is not applicable up to in this time of elements or the modern periodic table. So it didn't explain another, that is not exactly same towards the arithmetic mean of middle element atomic mass. So the John Dubernian gate failed to explain the or arrange the elements, periodic elements. Again, the law was gained in that is John Newland. He was gave the law, that is law of octaves. The law of octaves, that is, he say that very important and very simple, that every eighth element of periodic will repeat the property of first element, and which is correlate the seven Indian music note. What was the 7 Indian music note? That is, if you try to arrange, that is hydrogen, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen and oxygen. Again, the fluorine get started from there. Again, in one group there is fluorine, there is nickel and cobalt. Again, that is bromine. One more important thing that is At the time of Newland, there was 56 element or known, and that is he was arranged from hydrogen to thorium. Hydrogen to thorium. And but his law was only applicable. But देखिए first property में please को consider कर लेते हैं hydrogen. If we see the electronic configuration of hydrogen, and it want also one electron for this 70, and chlorine is also one electron for stability. Again, chlorine also one electron for stability. But also bromine also require one electron for stability of their outermost shell. But in case of nickel and cobalt, in this time, if you try to understand about saturation of nickel and cobalt, nickel and cobalt, if we, it is not possible. Draw the whole element. So suppose that here is iron. So after saturation of iron, iron, nickel, cobalt are the same in this time D block element. But fluorine, chlorine, bromine are the P block element because they are halogens. Because they show simple properties, same property. And but nickel and cobalt, these are different from these halogens because these are the metals. These are not non-metals. ये non-metals नहीं थी, ये तो metals थी. तो metal को metal में convert करना चाहिए, metal में इनको arrange करना चाहिए, लेकिन Newland वहाँ पे fail हो गए. They are not able to categorize their similar chemical and physical properties. They failed to keep the position of nickel and cobalt. So in this way, and here arrangement is also applicable only up to calcium. Here his application is applicable, his law is applicable only up to calcium. And he was also arranged their elements, their periodic classification into their increasing atomic mass as well as their properties, but roughly properties. And he did not give them any columns for the next another elements because on his time the 56 element was discovered. But Newland said, assume that there is no another element we are discovered in the future. That's why he didn't give the another columns. He only arranged the hydrogen to thorium. Means first was hydrogen and 56th was thorium. But in this time there is nothing like that. In this time there is 118 elements are arranged in the modern periodic table. Given by that is Henry Moseley. So some drawbacks also periodic classification of John Newland, and which he gave the law of octaves consider that the every 8 element it will repeat the property of first element. We can see it is, but it not sustainable. Okay, another video we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.